So good evening, friends, and welcome. This is just an informal concert. The background is that most of Indian classical music originated as a form of worship. We call it the Bhajana Sampradayam. The great composers, even people like Sri Tyagaraja, they have composed a lot of songs which can be sung in a group. Then the creative aspect of things started developing, like doing alapana, improvising with swarams, tanam, pallavi, and that raised it to another level of art music or creative music. So the positive side was that each artist, whether it's a singer, violin, percussionist, we all get a chance to explore our own creativity and bring our personal touch and color to anything we sing. The negative side was that along with the creativity, a lot of flamboyance, arrogance and competition also developed. So for example, in Pallavi singing, earlier in most kingdoms, the Maharaja, the ruler, would be himself an accomplished poet and a musician, and they would have a court musician who would be challenged by a visiting artist, and he will say, "I challenge you to a musical duel." So it would be a duet, which became a duel also, and the Maharaja would be the judge. So what he would do is that on the spot, he would make up a small line of poetry and prescribe, "You sing this line in this rhythm, in this raga." And on the spot, they had to compose Pallavi and do Trikalam, and Maharaja would be the judge. So suppose the outside musician won, then the resident musician would be so shamed that he would actually have to leave the country. So I feel music is not something for fight. We have so many other ways of fighting. So music should only be bringing people together. So, but since we have all these options of singing swaram and ragalapana and whatever, and showing off our virtuosity, complicated rhythms, voice range and all that, the negative thing was that the importance of compositions started to suffer. Many compositions are in Sanskrit, in Telugu, in Kannada, and many singers who don't know a word of Sanskrit or Telugu, they go around singing Tyagaraja Kritis, which are all in either Telugu or Sanskrit. Earlier, we did not have the facility of finding out. Me, for example, I was born and brought up in Trivandrum, and if I want to know the meaning of a Kannada Purandaradasa song, a Tyagaraja song in Telugu, in 1980s, there was absolutely no way. Now, things have changed with the internet. Most normal compositions, if we want to check Enduro Mahanubhavulu, we just go to Google and write Enduro Mahanubhavulu, lyrics and meaning. Immediately we'll get. But people are yet to make full use of the facility which is available. We use internet for so many other things, but these nice things also we can use the internet. So I don't claim to know Telugu or Kannada or any of these languages, but I'm constantly learning. So many songs which I know earlier, I've started correcting and tweaking the padachedam, or the, how we split the lyrics. This is one background of what made me do this concert. Then when it comes to composers, ragas, compositions, we have the superstars, Sri Tyagaraja Dikshitar, Maharaja Swaja Tirunal. We always say Trinity, Tyagaraja Dikshitar Shyama Shastri. But Shyama Shastri is not represented even 10% as much as Tyagaraja or Dikshitar are. But there are other composers also who are amazing, whom we don't get to hear that much. And ragas also, we hear Shankarabharanam, Kalyani, Bhairavi, Todi, Saveri, usual set of big ragas. But there are many other ragas which are very beautiful also. So this is kind of like a platform to present and bring to light some lesser heard compositions, sometimes by some lesser heard composers also. And since it's getting recorded, hopefully it will be preserved. I use this opportunity to learn these songs myself. So many of them are, I am still in the process of learning. So while singing I am learning also. So we'll start with a very beautiful Bhava Geeta. Bhava Geeta literally means emotional song, a song containing a lot of emotion, composed by my Guruji, Dr.M.Balamuralikrishna Balamuralikrishna. So this is a kind of not heavy classical, it's, we can call it a light composition, which is based on Raga Shankarabharanam, but it is not pure hardcore Shankarabharanam, what we see in Swara Raga Sudharasa, like that. So this is a very rare, special and beautiful composition, which is autobiographical. I had the privilege of spending 18 years with Balamuralikrishna sir, and many, many times I've had the privilege of actually watching him compose a song. You have to see it to believe how it would happen. It is not like he sits and writes the lyrics and then thinks, what tune should I put it in, and then write something, then slash it and correct. No, the entire composition with rhythm, melody and lyrics just comes out ready-made. So he would just sit and like this, he would frown and maybe hum a little bit, and either he would write it on a paper or he had a small tape cassette player, he would switch on and just sing and record. So it's so effortless, and I would ask him, sir, how do you do this? And every time his answer is the same. He says, I don't know, it comes. So really it comes, that's all. So, and he would always say, I don't know music, music knows me, like that. So he would compare himself to an instrument, like Vinu has a beautiful violin, but just the violin is not, it doesn't know music, it doesn't sing. The violin needs Vinu to play it, to create the music. So he would compare himself just to an empty instrument, and it is some divine force which plays music through him. And that idea is expressed in this composition. I won't give very long word by word explanation, then we can sing only two or three songs during the course of the evening, because each song is so rich in so much of background information and word by word meaning and specialities. But just one small idea. Paatale, this is addressed to music goddess herself. Paatale ni bhakti. All my songs, they are manifestations of my devotion to you. Baatala baatale, they are paths to attain you. And amrutapu tutale, they are dripping with amrutam. Amrutam, what is the English? Nectar, elixir, ambrosia. Yeah. So amrutam, they are dripping with ambrosia, which if you drink one drop of amrutam, you are immortal. That is the thing. Allade aapata, allade bhakti geetalapa madhuvahini tarangalave. So look at those songs. Allade is like ado, look like that. Bhakti geeta alapa, so devotional song rendition, madhu vahini tarangalave, it's a river of nectar, of honey. Tarangam are the waves. Then he describes himself, grolitini madhurasamu. I went and drank from that madhurasam. The madhu can mean both nectar and amrutam. Mrogitini muralivai. I became a flute. So Balamuralikrishna's signature is Murali, which means flute. Vralitini ni mrola, I came to you, kela gaikonuma, what my prayer to you, please listen. Then a paata sarenu, a baatale nenu, all those songs came through me and I imbibed them. A madhuvu grolaka madhupamu nenu, I became the bee, honey bee, which drinks from that honey. It's a poetic composition. So this is Shankarabharana based autobiographical song of Dr. Mangalampalli Balamuralikrishna sir.
Paatale, Paatale, Paatale.
Varakum.